1985, Coca-Cola decides to replace its old formula with a new one. Under protest, classic Coke returns. Actor Rock Hudson dies of AIDS. In 1985, MTV, Madonna, and street fashion influenced a generation, while the mainstream looked to dressed-up days. Furs and velvets made for fancy nights. Here's a look at the best of 1985 from the runways of the world.
At Perry Ellis, full cashmere coats are the staple of this young classic collection. Perry layers velvet for a new flirtatious silhouette. Navy suits follow a narrow line, but with fuller, deeper cut sleeves, and flirty skirts complete the feminine picture. Medieval theme sweaters are instant classics from Ellis. While harlequin suits get fun, flirty peplums from Perry. Side button jackets and slim pants show off the season's best colors. And Perry's color block sweaters are longer and leaner. Simple little slips of dresses are barely there in sexy satins. And for evening, Perry combines velvet with harlequin satins for fun, casual elegance. Bicolor satins are new and fresh from Ellis. A side-draped jacket and long, lean skirt are evening standouts. While a dramatically simple entrance maker is a stunner in satin and velvet. Black spells elegance for evening with a simple slip gown. But it's all out American elegance with a full-length sable. From Perry Ellis for fall 1985. All that fancy stuff is finished, declares Oscar de la Renta, who's taking a new pared-down approach to opulence. Houndtooth and Glen plaid suits get subtle touches of velvet elegance. And simple sheer jersey dresses are among the most flattering silhouettes for day or evening. Oscar's velvet-trimmed 7/8 coat easily tops a curvaceous velvet dress. Sequin sweaters with cashmere pants are evening dress-down headline makers. Oscar's lovely and easy paisley and floral separates are casual elegance for nighttime.
Thank you.
And what could be more practical than full-length wool evening coats? The perfect nighttime cover-up. But Oscar's signature opulence shines with beaded floral evening jackets. And jewel-encrusted boleros give a new umpire silhouette to a simple sheath. But it's show-stopping glamour with a satin full-length coat revealing an embroidered velvet gown. All-out American elegance for Oscar de la Renta. American sportswear for fall has never looked better. Here's the news wrap-up. Prints continue to play an important part in fall dressing. And look for oversized shirts and dandy-inspired waistcoats and pants layered for comfort. Motif sweaters were also a strong fall classic and look best when worn with the season's newest item, the ski or stirrup pant. For sporty evenings and casual elegance, coats are dressed up in deluxe fabrics. Dye Cheerling goes from day to evening with luxurious style. American sport at its best for fall winter 1985.
Designer Norma Kamali has rocketed to the stars with her unique sense of style and energy. For spring 85, Norma's designs explode with bright floral prints and a new sense of proportion. Her lengths are as long as ever, and what's newest is the flared trumpet skirt under a duster coat in that Kamali explosion of mixed florals. Even the simple dress is printed in daffodil yellow for one of spring's prettiest looks. And one of Norma's hottest patterns is brightly checked in a rainbow of pink, green, bright blue, and yellow. Even summer black gives gauze a sun-drenched air of mystery. And when mixed with white and swirled in nylon, Norma's evenings are stunning and sensational. Norma Kamali, New York's superstar fashion innovator. Willie Smith kicks off spring with an All Stops Out presentation for Willie Wear. This year, he takes us on a sightseeing tour. Using a wild array of backdrops and props, first stop, Jamaica, a languid setting for his casual sugarcane creations. Next, Metropolis with slick city suits. Then, on to LA for wild, gaudy prints. The country club scene is set with plaids in a garden of fresh colors, and the look just wouldn't be complete without white golfing shoes. Teeing off some of spring's best looks are his color and pattern matches, like grass green and pink. They're very good looking. And Willie's signature t-shirt dresses down the new short skirt suit. Last, it's a Punch and Judy puppet show in clownish light layers of white, including the ever-present duster coat. Willie Smith for Willie Wear, in fine form for spring 85 with young American looks.
Paris is still the world's fashion capital. It has the strongest sense of individuality, the strongest sense of style. There is something unique about Parisian fashion always.
I think when a designer, he has a good label, there is not anymore, new detail, some new idea, but what I am looking for is to give to women femininity.
And there's a big, big return for sort of real, true elegance with grace and allure. And a certain rigor, as I told you, but still, you know, being feminine and sexy.
The silhouette of big volumes can only be valuable anymore if it is counterposed by slim and shapes that show again the body. I think that the phase in which, influenced by a lot of things, we're trying to hide the body is over, but I think that there are different ways of showing it. I'm trying to find it in a subtle and discreet way. I think that a certain secrecy is part of the elegance of a woman.
You know, the women now, they are so conscious about the body that it is impossible to forget. It was very normal in the 60s or in the 50s, but now it's finished. The body is the most important thing for a woman today.
Paris is the one place that can take all the innovative ideas that maybe you find on the streets in London or in Tokyo in a whole young market, but they still have the way of putting it together and selling it back to us better than anybody else.
Azdeen Alaia continues to turn heads with his very sexy designs. Broad shoulder knits top the returning miniskirt for a shapely silhouette that's the Alaia signature. A creamy hooded cardigan blends perfectly with belted high-waist ski pants. And Azdeen thinks pink for warm, woolly crop sweaters and ski pants. But Azdeen's jackets show a body best, with nipped-in waist and broad shoulders. All-white coat dressing is a cool, elegant way to be warmed up this fall. And Azdeen sculpts leather coats with flared hems and trench details. While Robin Hood Green merrily colors a fitted flare bottom jacket with back interest. Azdeen's dresses bear the mark of his tailoring excellence in burnt red wool jersey. For luxury beyond compare, Azdeen designs his mink coats with fur inside and out, as well as his curved collar mink jacket. He shapes precious seal fur with trench details for dress-down elegance. And brass-buttoned, dandified jackets top skinny pants for this fall's important new trend. For nighttime glamour, Azdeen finally sculpts his statuesque gowns. But a mink cowl neck is the ultimate way to cover up or unveil his best. Azdeen Alaia, the master of body-revealing style for fall. Marité and François Girbeau continue to design easy and comfortable unisex sportswear. Short crop jackets and pleated trousers are surefire classics. Stonewashed denims, a Girbeau trademark, emerge season after season, newly stylized and treated. But all white layers add up to high style from casual, easy living separates. Olive drab is alive with bright, big shirts topping loose, easy trousers. And gray duffel coats barely contain multicolored jacquard sweaters and skirt topping ski pants. Girbeau leather coats are lined with sheepskin and oversized for cold weather comfort. And all black dressing adds drama to fall's dressed up days. Girbeau's parachute cottons take off in bright colored wing sleeve coats, big shirts, and peg leg pants. Black tie tuxedo dressing has a new comfort and wearability from Girbeau that's perfect for this season's dressed down nights. While rich jewel tones shimmer in taffeta separates for lazy evening classics. Marité and François Girbeau, easy sportswear with high style appeal. Never one to forsake the feminine form, Valentino mixes his sense of head-to-toe polish with glamorized sportswear that is streamlined and shapely. Fabrics make the point of looking what they are worth. This season, no one glamorizes the sweater like Valentino, with lamb's fur and cashmere quilt cardigans topping Shetland trousers and gaucho pants for a finely polished day look. Handsome coats with strong, round shoulders belt into curves at the waist, and top form-fitting sweaters and bright leather skirts. Valentino's red double-breasted blazers are collared with curly lamb's fur and accessories for the best of dressy day looks. And Valentino loves dressy days with luxurious separates, like body-molded leather lace blouses, elegant velvet tops, and supple leather skirts in red and black. The Valentino signature. Hourglass velvet coat dresses prove once again the most elegant and successful night looks are understated from Valentino. Curved and cropped paisley silk jackets reveal simple black velvet and wool sheaths, decidedly feminine. Luxurious fabrics are expertly mixed by Valentino, especially long lamé skirts with sleek, zippered leather lace jackets. Embroidered twin sets top silk pajama pants for sophisticated evening sportswear. Casual dressing has never been more in style, and Valentino masters dress down elegance with unmistakable fashion savvy. Less is more, with dramatically simple velvet gowns that are distinctly body conscious. Valentino, the grandmaster of Paris style. The news from Paris is felt throughout the fashion world, and what's in style is Paris style. Short skirts are on the rise, and the best barely skim the knee in a variety of luxurious fabrics. This season, strong shapes emphasize feminine curves, and the broad shoulder returns, giving new proportion to the body-conscious silhouette. High umpire waistlines return to high fashion with stately elegance for day and night. Paris style, a return to high style for fall 1985. High-energy designers from London continue to make worldwide fashion news. Here's the London News wrap-up. Shapes of the 60s continue to flavor English fashion. Opulent and luxurious fabrics give even sporty shapes high style and glamour. And classic period dressing is revolutionizing design. London, bursting with high-energy fashion ideas for fall 1985.
It's a new uprise of sort of young inspiration, yeah. I suppose.
There's a lot of people, creative people, and they're all emerging now that we've grown up with, and I should think that's one of the reasons. And it's all very confident and positive. Everyone's doing really good things, mm-hmm. and people are accepting it.
Mm-hmm. Two of London's most outstanding young designers are Body Map's Stevie Stewart and David Halla, who continue to create their unique high-energy style. This season, they put their energy into new romantic designs with a nostalgic 60s feel. From shiny bell bottoms to show-off ruffles, Body Map continues to redefine the body. Their prints mesmerize, especially when the fabrics are body-hugging and shapely cut. A new silhouette takes form when Body Map elongates sleeves and body wraps layers over layers, just for the fun of it. From mini skirts to mini dresses, no detail is complete without a Body Map touch of whimsy. A shirt-waist dress gets added impact from tux-inspired ruffles, And a matching duster is the finishing touch. But it's all out layers when flirty minis top skirts and pants. No body map show would be complete without bathing suits. The best are printed and ruffled, plus shiny and sexy. Body map, satin shines for evenings, but the twist is where to wear your skirt. And evenings also get a touch of gold with a super shiny trench and pants. And body map nights are black and magical with dusky velvets and ominous prints. But it's body wrapped gowns that reach new height. Non-stop high energy from Stevie Stewart and David Halla for Body Map. And Jasper Conran is true to his word. His belted iridescent trench coats are guaranteed to take the gloom out of the worst fall weather. And his soft, unstructured coats add that special Conrad zip to body-conscious hooded jersey dresses. Classic blazers and redding goats over twill jodhpurs complete the equestrian style that is British all the way. Cashmere jackets accented with neon-colored mink collars are this fall's surprise. Black bras come out of the closet and sizzle with dramatic sex appeal when glimpsed under one of Conrad's super sheer chiffon blouses. Simple lines and detailing spell sophistication this fall with ankle-length jersey separates. Brocade layering is subtle sophistication, perfect for that autumn evening. And the all-neutral silhouette looks anything but drab, with classic tailoring and leather accents. Fall evenings are made for the sleek elegance of Conrad's swirling black silk ensembles. While emerald green and amber brocade evening suits are the gems in this London designer's crown. ABC, ABC, I'm in love with you. Easy for me. Velvet T-neck dresses have the Conrad touch of simplicity and surprise. Your fall nights will receive a standing ovation with a velvet royal purple opera coat. England's Jasper Conran, classic high style.
This season, everything's coming up in Prince. It's a celebration of Betty Jackson's quick rise to London and worldwide fashion stardom. The unmistakable showstopper of this designer's spring collection is Brian Bulger's Big Rose print. Some of the best show up on big artsy t-shirts. They're worn with oversized, overall-style skirts and pants, too. The florals are even played against a giant windowpane plaid. There's a cartoon-like playfulness to these clothes, a welcome sense of whimsy that, for all its silliness, is very much in the modern fashion stream. Jackson turns florals into wearable art this season. Paintbox colors are splashed on kimono-style dresses. And patterns on patterns work in those soft, voluminous shapes. London's Betty Jackson, decorative design for Spring 85.
Listen as Italy's designers comment on the new season of sporty shapes and opulent fabrics.
There was the idea of mixing fake fur with real fur, using fur in a way normally you use material, mixing shapes, tight shapes, large shapes, very long thing, lots of pants, very tight pants, knit mixed with fur. And to use everything in a way one is not supposed normally to use it.
I think the women are working a lot, so they need some type of fashion that can follow them, not constrict them. Fashion to be not a problem, to be a help in the life. So that's the reason why I'm always try to make a loose fashion, something that is easy to wear, and in the meantime is quality, is very well designed, but I love soft design.
Non c'è una silhouette precisa come sempre, ma ci sono tante proposte per una donna moderna che non si lascia condizionare dalla moda, ma che usa la moda per se stessa.
No? I think all new situation from the heart, or from the music, or from the movie, give much inspiration at the designer for the collection. Me, I take many inspiration from Prince, because it's all generation, young generation, like new romantic.
That's the best, the most important thing. No colors, no trendy colors, no trendy volumes, lengths, or fabrics. But the most important thing that makes everything easier is to feel comfortable with ourselves.
Crizia, designed by Mariuccia Mandelli, is one of the most famous names in Italian fashion. For fall 1985, she's designed her most commercial line of day wear yet. This year, the Crizia animal motif is a very appealing fox, and its natural tawny color plays an important part in the Crizia color story for fall. Jodhpurs are the new pant shape here and elsewhere in Milan. Sumptuous leather gives Crizia sportswear added elegance. Still one of the best suit shapers in the world, Mandelli mixes strong-shouldered silhouettes with curves and femininity. All the coats are outstanding, no matter what length, and the colors are usually bright and primary. Mandelli teams these brights with basic black for added appeal. Easy easy knits are shaped for comfort and style. And the Crecia fox appears again, this time draped as a dramatic and colorful stole. And fur jackets are works of art from Crecia. Searching for inspiration in evening wear, Crecia journeys to India, where the looks range from shiny Nehru jackets to draped harem pants. An extravagant assortment of gold, bronze, and other precious metals, molded into luxury evening wear worthy of a king's ransom. Italian tailoring in full force for fall winter 1985. Franco Moschino makes a strong and very individual statement in Italian design this fall. He believes in dressing with a sense of humor and allows women a greater freedom of choice. Fashion is entertainment for Moschino, and his approach is unique. He takes a tongue-in-cheek look at the establishment design houses. And Moschino goes to all lengths to make a fashion statement. Traditional styling gets an offbeat twist from Franco, right down to the accessories. But Moschino's design talent comes through with a versatile dress that can be worn many different ways. It starts out draped and fitted to the body for sex appeal with a new body-conscious silhouette. Moschino takes the same dress one step further, now with a flowing tent shape for soft femininity. Moschino suits are tailored classics with mix and match separates. Spandex ski pants are paired with a 1960s flavored military jacket for a jaunty new combination. His playfulness returns, this time over a bright red, sexy fringe skirt. Moschino, A Touch of Humor for Fall 1985. The very French and flamboyant Claude Montana designs for Complice in Milan. This fall, he starts out making a strong gray and black color statement with soft alpaca jackets cut longer in the back than in the front, worn over floppy trousers, Charlie Chaplin style. Shirt tails almost always get pulled out, especially over trousers that narrow down, cuffed at the ankle. Big winter coats are boldly colored in violet. Then, cinched at the waist to emphasize the broad padded shoulders and unusually high collars. Montana crops his big coat into short, savvy jackets that get added punch when paired with complementing patterns. And long-ribbed turtleneck sweaters are designed to peek out of short-waisted jackets. Luxuriously sporty shearling coats and jackets also pair up with the all-important sweater. Montana uses soft leather for more body-conscious outerwear that's designed with broad, wide shoulders and oversized collars. He is also a master of body-conscious knitwear that flatters the figure. And for evening, the formal cutaway in purple requires only the basic black trouser. Complice is a collection of young, fun fashion from Milan's flamboyant Frenchman, Claude Montana. The news from Milan. It's rich, it's sporty, it's luxurious. The Milanese are building their shapes from important broad shoulders and narrow hips. It's also a season where designers are mixing sporty and lavish fabrics with total abandon. And as each designer stresses his or her own style, the overall sensibility remains Italian style for autumn-winter 1985-86.
Giorgio Armani, the most important Italian designer of the decade. He's in top form for Spring 85. This is a brilliant collection, one of the best ever. It's easy, elegant fashion from the man who's created some of the best man-tailored clothes ever. And now he's done something incredible. He's removed most of the masculine touches with pure, easy shape. What remains is nothing but clean line, pure design. Now here's a surprise. He's adding pure, bright color too. Sometimes just a touch of it. The shirt, the key statement from every Milanese collection this season, is truly outstanding in the hands of this fashion genius. Armani has a sense of humor, too. He breaks tradition and makes the shortest statement of the year. For evening, the shirt, of course, is a standout. With shorts and ties, the look is distinctively, playfully Armani. Even his blazers take little bandeau bras for simple, sexy appeal. Shoulders are bared and hips are wrapped, drawing attention close to the body. If in this season of marvelous shirts, there is one that epitomizes the new evening attire, this is it. Simple shapes by Armani are done in sequins to add a low-keyed note of easy elegance. Silk sweaters are casually tied around the hips. Armani's new evening clothes are at the forefront of what's really evolving in fashion today. It's a modern look for the 80s. And his shimmering paillettes enter the late night picture with surprising, sexy, hot pants. Giorgio Armani is Milan's leader. He makes women look sexy and modern. We'll be right back.